Yep, can still see it. Oh, a little bit heavier this time. Put the key back in my pocket. Well, Dad doesn't have anything to worry about. That did better than I thought. Fortunately, it's a dry snow. He said, oh shoot, when I told him about the amount of fun I was gonna have because of the amount of snow, because he was thinking about the greenhouses here. Problem is, this is a dual poly, and there's nothing but air in between the two layers. So really, you have a roof that is about 6 millimeters thick, less the airspace. So, if it gets too heavy, these things can actually collapse. So normally we would have heaters on, pumping out some heat, fueled by gas made from trash back in the landfill in back of us that we get for free. We don't pay a penny for gas. And that is sweet. I think a little something on the generator here, now that I'm back here. We had the master switch go bad. That switches the current supplied to the greenhouses from normal to the generator. Well, apparently they've got it fixed because the generator's in automatic and it's not running. Problem we had was it would be in automatic and running all the time because it thought the power was out. But they got that fixed. Let's go fill the Kubota up. Well, full tank of fuel. Let's hope the batteries are just as full. And once again, maybe I've got some new subscribers, but guys, this tractor really does need up to 1 minute of preheating, as you can see right there. 20 to 30 or even 20 to 60 seconds, depending on the temperature. So to those of you who were thinking that 20, 30, even 60 seconds is way too long, that's just what Kubota tells you right there. Let's see what that does, shall we? Come on. Yeah, fired right up. Perfect. Now I'll just have good. 3-point hitches on there, ready to hook up to the plow. We are golden. To pull these off though. I like to let it warm up. That way it warms up the fluid used to raise the drawbar up and down, because otherwise you'll be waiting forever for this thing to go up and down. I just realized I forgot my stocking cap. My poor ears. Remember, four-wheel drive for the win. There we go. High gear, four-wheel drive. Here we go. Don't forget to close the door. Go over and get some wrenches, and up to the plow we go. go get some wrenches. We can open these bars up here to put the plow on. All right, so up to the plow we go. Looks like Dad got the blower out. That's the way to do it. This thing's been sitting here about a year or more.
Yeah.
Oh wait, where did I put my wrenches? Oh no, they're right here, right where I left them. All right, loosen these up so we can use the 3-point to hook up to the plow. All right, I got my little plow hooked up. It ain't much, but this will meet another video request. Let's go plow!